How can I update SharePoint columns from individual cell data in an Excel form, not Excel tables, using both the Excel desktop and online web apps? And without being nagged to death to use Power Apps? I'll show you, but no promises on the nagging. Yeah, I've held back on answering this question as it encourages a method of form management that's past its sell-by date. But there are pockets of individuals still giving users Excel forms for quotes, bids, annual leave requests, timesheets, incident reports, the list goes on. If this sounds like something your organization is still doing, Microsoft, Google, Adobe, they're all providing online development tools that your organization should be embracing to make everyone's lives so much easier. Microsoft in particular have provided the Power Platform, and you've probably heard of this before by now. But many people can't find the time or don't feel comfortable learning this new platform of tools. They were designed with end users in mind, but there is a steep learning curve for many. So watch this video to the end to see what I'm doing to help resolve this. Anyway, so I'm gonna try and disable old man lecture mode, because you Excel managers and form managers in particular have probably heard this use Power Apps lecture and still waiting for a solution. So lecture mode off. Anyway, the irony of all this is, realistically, Power Automate is the quickest and easiest method with the fewest issues. So we'll be using the Excel Data Connector to do this. Now, anyone who's worked with the Excel Data Connector will say it only connects to Excel data tables, not individual cells. Correct. And that is exactly what I will do. I will use an Excel table to manage your individual cells and push them to SharePoint columns. Bear with me. I'm going to walk you through the process from creating a new Excel form, purely because I haven't got one. I'll connect the data ready for SharePoint pushing, and then I will upload this new workbook as a library template, very quick, and then off to Power Automate to create it. This will allow you to enter the data in Excel, and it will update to SharePoint. It will not work in reverse. If you want something like that without code, learn Power Apps. Seriously, it's not worth the hassle. So I'm going to start with a new template, but you can use any form you want, even an existing one. And I'm going to do one on a quotation. Now, for this example, I'm going to select three cells and place their data into SharePoint columns. So I'm going to highlight them in yellow so you can see which ones they are. Now, for each range, I'm going to select and create a name. You don't have to do this. I'm doing this mainly for a visual purpose. So I'm going to create a brand new sheet, and this is where I'm going to grab the cells data and put it into an Excel data table. So I'm going to create a range heading for each. But I also need a heading for a unique ID so I can identify the data in Power Automate. The good thing is every form you fill in will always be ID 1. So let's select that table, go to insert, click table, and we're going to insert that into a table. So because we have a header row, we've got a blank row underneath it. And now I'm going to pull the data via their range name. So equal range name. You can do equal and then the cell reference. It both works quite effectively. We need to specify the table in Power Automate later, so let's give it a recognizable name. I'm going to use TBL quote data. I'm going to rename the sheet as well, but we don't need the sheet name in Power Automate. So I'm going to enter some data just to make sure that it's coming through the table, and I'll format it, but that's not really important. I'm using a text string for the numbers anyway. Right. Time to hide that sheet. I don't want the user seeing it. So let's just right click and hide. And finally, I'm going to reformat the sheet so it kind of represents how it would look if it was live. So I'm just going to put some data in here. That'll do. I couldn't think of anything else. Right, and save it and put it on my desktop. So I have the form ready. It's on my desktop. Now I need a library to assign this to. So I'm going to create a new document library. Any site will do. So I'm going to click new here, document library. I'm going to call this quotes. There we go. My Excel forms are going to get stored in here. I need three columns though to store the data into. So I'm going to create these three columns. Customer ID, company name, and the quote one. And these are the ones that the Excel data that I highlighted are going to be plopped into. I will now add that Excel workbook as a new template. So new, add template, and on my desktop, the quote workbook, and open. I'm going to click back on new because all the other templates I don't want the users using except quote. So I'm going to edit the new menu and I'm going to untick everything else except quote and save. The last thing to do here is to add a sample quote into the library, and this is going to become very important later on. So I'm just going to fill it in with any mock data. There you go. And that should do lovely. And I'm going to save that quote into the library. Phase one is complete. Phase two is to go into Office here and run Power Automate. As always, I'm going to do this from scratch. I'm not going to use any templates. So I'm going to click Create. And we use an automated Cloud Flow. And let's call this one Update Quote Data Columns. And I'm going to use to the trigger a SharePoint file based trigger. And this one is going to be when a file is created or modified, but I want to grab the properties only. I'm only grabbing the columns, not the file. Specify what site the trigger's to look in and what library. I'm going to pick the quotes one. Now it's important not to pull the data from Excel straight into the SharePoint columns because you're going to keep the Excel file open and it will keep it locked. So we need to put them into variables first, close Excel, and then we can open up SharePoint. So we're going to create some variables to store the data. So we'll create a new step with an action using the variables, and we're going to initialize a variable. In fact, we're going to initialize three of them. So we're going to pull this in three times, and I'll put my column name in for each. And again, I'm going to use string for all of these just to keep it simple. Now, because these actions will have similar names, I'm going to go into the ellipsis in the top right corner, click rename, and I'm going to just add the variable name at the end so they stand out more. And this is just so that I can tell which one's which quickly inside the expressions window later. You don't have to do this, whatever makes it easier for you. So now we have our variables. I'm going to open up the Excel book and pull the data into them. So I'm going to use the Excel get row action, which is in the Excel online business data connector. And I need to choose the SharePoint site and the library where all the quotes are being stored. And that's where I'm going to pull the file in from. The problem is I want to pull in whatever file was triggered at the top. So I want to go to this trigger list of properties and pick the identifier. Problem is that is not an actual physical file. It's just telling it what file to grab when it runs. And therefore, when I go to table, it can't find the table names. It won't be able to find any of my columns. And if I go and create an action, so in a moment, I'm going to do a set variable. And that's where I'm going to pull the data into the variables. But at the moment, when I choose a variable, I cannot grab the data from the getter row because it's not listed. I've implied what the file will be, not explicitly told it what the file was called. So I need to change my tactics here. What I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna get rid of that identifier temporarily. I'll put it in later. But in order for me to get all the pop-ups, I've got to explicitly specify an actual file. So that's why we built that quote sample earlier. Now I can see the table name because it's pointing straight to the file that exists already. Pull the key column and put in the key value, which don't forget is always going to be one. And now if I click new step and again, looking for that set variable, there it is. And when I specify the variable I want and go to value and scroll down, you'll see the get row has now appeared and I can pull in all the data I want. So in this case, I'm going to pull in the customer ID and I'm going to repeat that for the other two sets of data that I need. So I'm going to set variable, choose the company name and pull up the company name from the getter row. So set variable and pick up the quote total. Let's just rename these because they all look similar again. So optionally, let's rename them. I'm just going to put the variable name at the end so I can easier identify which is which. Now I have the dynamic content I need, I'm going to go back into get a row. I'm going to remove that file name. I'm going to expand the variables first so you can see that they won't disappear, that data stays in there. If I remove that file name and replace it with the triggers identifier dynamic content, so it's lost its connection to that file I explicitly defined. So I'm going to remove that table GUID. I'm going to type in the actual name of the table, TBL quote data, and I'm going to add that as a custom value. And there all the dynamic content still retains and still works. Now that I have the data in memory, I can allow that getter row to close the file down. It takes a little while. And now I can go into SharePoint and use the update file properties to connect to the metadata of the file. So I'm going to specify the site name, the quotes library, and the ID is the ID of the list connected to the file. That should be the ID from the trigger at the top there. And now I'm going to specify the title, which I haven't changed that. So I'm just going to go and grab the title and say, just keep it as it is. Same with the description. There it is. And with the customer ID, company name and quote total, I'm going to pop in the variables. And that just updates the columns. Now I've got one more here, and this is actually for a later demonstration, but it's just going to put a date in. And this is to show that you can add other data besides Excel at the same time. So with this one, I'm going to use an expression. I'm going to use UTC now, which pulls in the current date and time and just populates it into that column. And there we go. Now there are two issues you may get from this, and these are in separate videos. One is when you open up an Excel workbook, it's locked for shared use and it takes a little while before Excel closes it down. So between the getter row and the point where we go and update the file properties of that file, the file may be locked. And that's the first issue. The second one is when you update the file properties, updating is what the trigger's looking for. So when you update the file here, it's going to re-trigger the workbook, or it's most likely going to trigger that. So how do we get around that? Now, I've not put this in the video because A, overcomplicates it. B, you may not have these issues. So if you do get these issues, there is a video on how to deal with the error 400 file is locked for shared use. And we've also got a video that shows you how to prevent an infinite loop on the trigger. So those videos you can see are linked at the top here and you can go and have a look at them if you get those issues. So the only thing remaining is to test and see if this works. So I'm going to save the flow, click test, and I'll do a manual test. So this means I'm just going to go in and create a new form. For speed, I'll create the form using Excel Online, but you can use online or desktop. They'll both work with this. So if I close this workbook down, return back to Power Automate, and the flow is already running. And it seems to pick up the file and there's the data. Very, very quick indeed. Click like, click subscribe, ask me questions that you want answers to and post your request to John Day Q&A on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Reddit, Instagram, TikTok, Bebo. Yeah, Bebo. And you remember Bebo? It's back. I'm not sure how popular it is, but I'm on there as well. Also, very important, I am releasing 20-minute lessons on the Power Platform and SharePoint to get your data into a new, fresh look, new, fresh appeal. So I'm going to be in 20-minute snippets. Should be able to pick them up in lunchtime or break times. And these will be complete scenarios in 20 minutes that you can go back and try. Okay. The channel is Data Academy. It's online. There's nothing in it yet. We are producing the videos now. But if you subscribe to Data Academy, you'll be notified when those videos come out. And hopefully, we are going to be producing for you and your organization all these lovely little sessions on Power Apps, the Power Automate, Power BI, and SharePoint, and lots more. We'll be taking you through different snippets from the ground up. So this is aimed at people who are end users and don't have any background whatsoever on these tools. Data Academy is also providing e-learning programs. So if you're interested in that, you can go to their website, dataacademy.com, and have a look at that content. Stay safe and have fun learning the Power Platform.